This conference will now be recorded.
Just a minute, please. We'll start in a minute. Hello, guys. Good evening. Hope I'm audible to you all. Yes, of course. If you find any difficulty in listening to my voice, please ping me here. Okay. I think I have already shared my screen, and you were able to see some notepad file opened on my screen. Okay. So hope you are able to see. If you find any difficulties, please let me know, or we can do that. Okay, fine. Okay, guys. Good evening. If you are already attended workshop, so it's okay, fine. Again, today we are going to be discuss about Android. But before that, who are the new joiners today? So for them, I am introducing myself. So this is Chari. I have overall 13 years of Android real-time experience. So I worked in various domains like Java web application domain as well as .NET framework I worked. After that, I changed to Android mobile application development. So from there to now, still I am working for a Android application developer. My job is to provide architect for the client, and used to interact with the team, make my application, get it done by development team. That is the thing I am having. Okay, so this is my history, and as a part time I am working for Durgesa, having a couple of sessions in a day. Okay, so that too 1 hour 1 hour in the morning or evening. Okay, so today we are starting for a new batch, for 8 p.m. batch. Okay, right. So regarding this Android demo, what are all I am going to be teach to you? Let me give you the clarification. Like, what is that? So first I will explain you what is Android. Okay, so what is the history of Android during our Android application development? So what are all the components, real-time components I am going to be discuss with you? So the way how I am going to be explain example as well as advanced topics with you. So all these things I am going to be covered today. Okay, right. So first I'll make you understand what is Android first. Okay. So Android is nothing but, see, yesterday I have written, same one I am repeating today. See, Android is nothing but the definition of Android, we can say it is software stack for developing Android applications. So these Android applications, either it should be, you are going to be targeted for mobiles or tablets. So in the market, in the existing current market, we have n number of devices with a different resolution of screens, right? Some devices have 4 inch, 4.4 inch, 4.5 inch, 4.7 inch, 5 inch, 5.2 inch, 5.8 inch kind of thing. 7 inch, 10 inch tablets and mobiles are available. Even though smartwatches, Android smartwatches also available in the market. Along with that, Android software, smart TVs also available in the market for us. Okay, along with this, for infotainment domain is nothing but a car. Even using Android operating system, you are going to be implement applications for Android. So these are the different usages about Android operating system, what it was defined, and the definition what I am telling you here is it's a software stack for developing Android application. Here either one you are going to be choose, or the application what you are going to be generated, that must satisfy with all these things. Okay, either should be happened based upon your client requirement. So whatever the course we are learning during this thing, so you are going to be get all these details. Okay, right. So if you learn my course, so the same will be applicable for mobiles, tablets, as well as Android TVs, as well as smartwatches, even Android apps. Okay, that is one. For any application, it is common. So first, I will make you understand what is software stack. See, actually, software stack, we can call it as a framework. You can call it as a framework technically. So what is framework? So framework is nothing but some bunch of libraries. Some bunch of libraries are placed. From that, you are going to be pick your things. What you would like to design exactly. Okay. So that is a framework. So framework technically we can call in point of Android, we are calling it a software stack. So basically what is a framework means? Framework is nothing but it's a plan with semi implemented. So Android operating system have some architecture. That architecture have some components. Those components we can call it as framework components or Android SDK. Okay. So what is this we can call? Android SDK, Android Software Development Kit. Using this software development kit only, you are going to be implement these kind of applications. There is nothing outside the Android operating system. Without these components, you can't do anything. Okay, keep it in mind. So you are going to be generate an application with the help of Android SDK. So if I learn Android SDK, then am I able to design my application? Yes. It's possible. So however, all the applications existing in the world with the Android operating system, so similar you are going to be generating. Same, not similar, it's same. So those kind of applications you are going to be generated with the Android SDK. Okay, before learning about these things, so first I would like to explain you about the thing about how Android got generated. So actually this story began in the year 2004 and 2005. In the United States of America at California state. Okay, there is a company. So there is one founder for the company. His name is Andy Rubin. Okay, Andy Rubin is one of the founder for the company. So we don't know the company name. So Andy Rubin is a like he is a kind of founder as well as developer for that company. He owned that organization. And in the year before that 2000 or 1990s itself, we have plenty of smartphones available in the market. Okay, of course, India, we have at that time very normal mobiles. But if you compare with other countries, iPhone is very famous, Samsung with in South Korea, okay, Chinese mobiles kind of. They have their own setup for the smart phones. So Andy Rubin, what he thought is, let's start implementing a product which has to satisfy or to compete for the other mobiles. So what is his main implementation or what is his main motto is, he would like to implement a open source mobile operating system. So what is open source is? Open source is nothing but it's for free of cost. So other things are there for proprietary. For example, iPhone is there for us. So for example, in your iPhone, if you would like to download any content from the iPhone application, you must pay something and then you could able to download. So it's not like that in Android. That's the reason Android becomes very famous. What is the main reason? It's a open source mobile operating system because it will be available for free of cost. You can download the Android operating system for free of cost. You can implement your applications for free of cost. You can also upload, you could also upload your applications into Google Play Store for free of cost. Okay, that is the main motto. So he got his thought in the year 2004, but unfortunately whatever Andy Rubin company is there, that was acquired by Google. So you know what is the Google nowadays we have, that Google was acquired that company. So what happened? So Google acquired means Andy Rubin also become a employee of and Google. So Andy Rubin, he explained same thought to Google. Okay, Google also started, they said okay for the agreement and they started investigating. Like what are the requirements for the open source mobile operating system development. So they have engineers to develop software, but the main motto is how to make product marketing.
See, we are developing a product, right? So we have to make some market. How to grab the market? So what is the special feature of this operating system is open source. So open source means if you implement your own mobile, then it cannot compete with other mobiles in the market. So what Google thought in this process is they formed a committee. Google formed a committee with the name called OHA. Please remember this. This OHA, it was established in the year 2005 by the Google. Okay. What is OHA is Open Handset Alliance. This is very, very important point. You will definitely, in any interview, they may ask you, what is OHA? So OHA is nothing but Open Handset Alliance, which is nothing but it's a free mobile group. It's a free mobile group. So if you become, for example, I am a mobile vendor. Consider I own my mobile hardware. Like I am a mobile vendor. So that mobile hardware I have with me. So if I become the member of OHA, then Google will allow me to install that open source mobile operating system into my device for free of cost. Example, Samsung is loading with the Android operating system. But before that, Samsung is having their own operating system, Bada. Nokia, very recently it was become member of OHA. But before that, we have Symbian operating system. Kind of, different kind of mobiles have their own setup. But later, once this open source mobile operating system, it was released into the market, then slowly every mobile vendor, they have started migrating into Android. That is open source mobile operating system. So actually in the year 2009, Google released one open source mobile operating system with the name called Android, behalf of Andy Rubin. Until and unless before 2009, the working title of Android is open source mobile operating system. Okay. So since from 2009, we got n number of operating system released into the market. I'm going to be write all those things with the names here. So all the names are in alphabetical order. Okay, let me type all those things. See, first working title, they named it as Alpha. Later they named it as Astro, which was released in the year 2009. Next, second one, Bender is there. So which is called Beta. These are all the Android operating system versions names. Next, Cupcake, alphabetical order. Everything is alphabetical and sweet names. Okay, Donut, Eclair, Froyo, you must remember all these names. Next, you will have Eclair, Froyo. Okay, next you will have Gingerbread. Next, Honeycomb, Ice Cream Sandwich. I'm typing slowly for your convenience. Next, you will have Jelly Bean. Okay, after this, I'm making separate because from here we got very huge market. From Lollipop operating system onwards, we got n number of new features added into the mobile operating system, Android operating system. Because of that reason, we are occupying 85% global market in the world. You know what is the current value of Android operating system global market? It is 85% market we are occupying. Like in the entire world, if you consider 100 people, 85 people, they are using Android mobiles, and we are satisfying their 85 people requirements as per our applications. Okay. So Lollipop. Next, you will have Marshmallow, Nougat, Oreo. Next version, Q has to release. It was got delayed with the Corona. Okay, but every year in the month of November, they used to release the new version. Because of the Corona, this has not happened this year. So that's the reason we got some fluctuation in the market, because iPhone 12 got released with enhanced feature, but definitely Q will get more than that. I'm sure. Okay. So we'll compete more than iPhone, definitely. So Q has to release very soon. We will get it. Okay, these are the different version names: Astro, Bender, Cupcake, Donut, Eclair, Froyo. Oh, sorry, twice I have written. Gingerbread, Honeycomb. Okay, so ice cream sandwich, Jelly Bean. Sorry, Kit Kat I didn't write. I forgot it. One second. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K. Kit Kat. L, I have written lollipop, marshmallow, nougat, Oreo, pie, Q. Q has to release now. Okay. So whenever they are releasing, okay. So why these guys are released these many means? They are keep on adding n number of features. Okay. So those n number of features, where can I find? Actually, Android have a particular website for us. This is official website which will be maintained by Google. From this website, you can get all the information about the Android. developer.android.com, which will be maintained by Google. Okay, in the Google developer.android.com website, you will find all the information related to the Android plot, Android stuff. So Android has to release with the new things. What are all it is going to be have? See some sample code, test your code. These things they are going to be provided. But before that, let me make you understand what kind of platform it is providing now. So Android is now Q has to release with 11, with the latest version of Android. So you will get all the things here. Like what they are introducing, Camera X, a new Jetpack library they are adding, Android 11 with what are the new features available, okay, TV products, Android Auto products, things, okay, all these things they are going to be provided in the Android 11, okay. So what kind of releases we have until now? So all the information. See here, you get Android 11, so you have Android 10, Pie, Oreo, Nougat, Marshmallow, Lollipop, KitKat. Let me go to the dashboards. Distribution dashboard. Here you will have screen sizes, all the information like this. So what is the each version have what ratio? You will find here. Okay. So what kind of versions we are doing? For example, in the Android Pie, what are the new versions they have given? So what are the APIs? I'll make you understand what is API, but before that, see here, I'm getting some information from Android versions with API level. So these are the different names which was released from the Android. Okay. One second, let me copy and paste over there so that you can get understand. Okay, it is not mandatory to remember API levels. Okay, so it is not mandatory. What is the latest version? That version, if you remember, that's enough. Okay, so let me come from starting. As I told you, first version name is Astro. When they have released in the year 2009, so the working title Alpha or Astro. So their version of operating system is 1.0. API. What do you mean by API is application programming interface. So what features they have integrated inside this, that they named. Okay, that they named it as version. API level. Application programming interface. It contains all the features. For example, before that I will show you. For example, here I have Android 9 features and APIs. Indoor positioning with Wi-Fi RTT. Okay. Display cutout support. Okay. This is the kind of thing. So if I would like to implement this application, so how? And these kind of new notification user interface they have given. Okay. So enhanced messaging things. That kind of code they have provided here. See, the code is available. This code is available is nothing but we can call it as API, application programming interface. That kind of these programs, if you would like to find, you can find the features as well as along with what kind of code you have to write for that, they are going to be provide the description here. Okay, so they will give, for example, I would like to positioning with Wi-Fi. So this one in the settings location, we have to do something. Okay, so that Android demo application is there. So Android Wi-Fi artist can, let me go there. See, this is direct sample code they have provided to you. Okay, so this is scanning for Wi-Fi. So how to get the scanning Wi-Fi things. So these kind of APIs, which contains all the code for you, from scratch. Okay, how to implement that? Okay, how to write its logic? Okay, what kind of things you have to use? Everything here, it is available for you. Okay, this is the thing. So you no need to worry about much. How, if I got a new version of Android, so how can I learn these things? Don't worry, it's relevant APIs they are going to be provide, programming interface with samples. Using that, you can learn simply. Okay, so second version, it is Bender or beta. So what is its version? 1.1. Its API level is 2. Next, Cupcake, what is its version? 1.5. next, its API level is 3. But here one more thing is there here, NDK. What is NDK? Native Development Kit. SDK in the sense, this is kind of code. Okay, native development, it is also code, but native development is different actually, which will support for hardware abstraction layer, HAL, hardware abstraction layer programming, that we can call it as NDK. Okay, so NDK, for whom it is applicable is the people who are working for Google, okay, Redmi, what are the mobile vendors are there, right? Samsung, for them, their company will provide a HAL. At that time, you will get separate training. Okay, what is that project? Okay, so what they have written for the code? So what feature have which class? You will have separate coding. That's a different actually. So what are all the versions here available? I am writing here. Okay, one second. Let me make this one alignment perfectly so that you can understand all the version names. API level is this one, so don't get confused and don't worry, everything I am going to be explained as in easy manner. Okay, so here just I am aligning the data, so to give more information about Android versions. You no need to learn about API levels, just you need to know what is the latest API version, because in the code we are going to be at, your application will support what minimum operating system, what is the target operating system you are doing. Okay, so the latest API version is Android 11 is the version. Its name is Android 11, code name is Android 11. Its API level is Android API level 30. So Q will release with the 31. So these are all called developer version, don't get confused. So what is the 10, 11, 9, 0, all these things, we can call it as developer version. Okay, this is version. Okay, this is the API level. Or NDK. So NDK, they stopped from ice cream sandwich. Okay, so because latest version doesn't contain any NDK changes, so they are concentrating on operating system software development kit only. NDK they stop. Okay, because the hardware become constant. So this is the latest version. These names are going to be renamed with Q. So you can suspect that these API levels are 30, 29 and 30 for the Q. Okay, so all the names are there. See here, Alf, Astro, Bender, Cupcake, Donut. Eclair has released for 3 times with version 2.0 to 2.1 with API levels 5 to 7. Froyo 1 time, Gingerbread 2 times, Honeycomb 3 times, Ice Cream Sandwich 2 times, Jelly Bean 2 times, KitKat 1 time, Lollipop 2 times, Marshmallow 1 time, Nougat 2 times, Oreo 2 times, Pie 1 time, like this. Why these got, means some bugs they observed, so they rectified the bugs and they released a new version. So every time you will get updates for your when you become a developer. Okay, so how to get the those things also I am going to be teaching you. Right, these are the different versions what we have. Okay, so with the latest version, what it contains, those things only we are going to be discussed. Okay, this is some history with version names. Okay, next, how to create an Android application. So what are the requirements? So what are the requirements for me to start implementing Android application? So first I will go through with the system requirements. System in the sense about your PC. Your PC must need 8 GB RAM. Even though 8 GB RAM, it will become very slow. So sometimes it will take more time to execute. Okay. A hard disk, there is no particular limitation. And Android operating system, what it is? It is platform independent. So you are using either Linux operating system or Ubuntu, or either you are using Windows, whatever you can use, it will support any of the platform. Okay, it is completely platform independent. Okay, so any operating system, it's fine for me. I'm using Windows operating system here. So same thing will be happen. Even though you are using Windows, Ubuntu, whatever it is, you are going to be download Android Studio IDE. So what is this IDE? Integrated Development Environment, where you are going to be create your application and then add your front end as well as write your back end logic. So that is Android Studio IDE. One question here. I'm asking one question. What is this is? Is it mandatory to use Android Studio IDE, or there is no other IDEs available in the market? Only Android Studio is only the option. Even though it is available, which are not supported for Android application development. Keep it in mind, which IDE you have to use? Only Android Studio. So Android Studio IDE also platform independent. You can use Ubuntu or Linux or Windows or Mac, anything, okay? Any kind of operating system, it don't care. You can get that one. You can download it from free. You can download Android Studio from developer.android.com website for free of cost. Let me select this Android Studio. So it will load here, Android Studio, download Android Studio, 64-bit. If I try to this one, see, it will try to download the .exe file. I have already downloaded and installed. So like this you will get, okay? This is the Android Studio where you are going to be write logic. You are going to be design any, this is XML language. So application will be created like this. This is XML. When you are creating application, the user interface will be displayed. Okay, so where you can adjust your views, okay, with the by providing its attributes, that I am going to be teach to you how to use APK analyzer, how much memory it is taking, okay, how you can execute your application using virtual device. Okay, so here before that, let me make you understand, you have to download Android Studio IDE. After that, you must set up Java environment. Okay, so this tomorrow I am going to be explain to you how to set up Android Studio along with the Java environment. Okay, these two are mandatory for me. Other than that, nothing is required. Nothing is required. Okay, so in Android Studio only we have to implement our application. So this is one. Why? My question is, why Android Studio only? So why Android is not supporting with other things? Okay, so why it is not supporting? The important thing is Android Studio, it was loading with the Gradle build, okay, which was released with Gradle plugin. Come down here, let me show you that one. Android Gradle. Okay, so what is this Gradle? So I will make you understand technically. Up to Jelly Bean KitKat, we are using Eclipse IDE to implement our Android applications. You know, if you very well know about Java, if you are aware about how to write Java coding, right? So those guys will use Eclipse more. Earlier, we also working with Eclipse up to KitKat version. But from Lollipop operating system onwards, Android introduced a new concept into the market, which is highly advanced, which is called material design concept. Material design concept. So what is this material design concept? Like, I'll tell you, this material design concept is nothing but, so who are already experienced in Java, like struts, Hibernate kind of thing. So all of you know about Maven, right? Maybe if you don't know also, I will try to explain you more. So Maven is a kind of Java project where if you would like to create any application kind of Maven, you need to use many number of libraries which you have to download it from internet and then place it into your application. So instead of downloading in yourself and placing into application, so we will provide that library URL, Maven dependency, we can call it is Maven dependency URLs. We are going to be writing configuration file. So that configuration file, what it will do when your application or your Eclipse connected, or whenever your IDE connected to internet, it will start downloading from internet what are all the relevant libraries required for my Maven application. Okay, all the libraries will be downloaded and it will keep it in a folder. So from there I can easily access into my application so that I can implement a very good application, which is very highly visualized, high-end visualization concepts. So those concepts are available in the material design concepts. So instead of using Maven, what Google planned, they have taken supported from other than Maven, we have Gradle kind of project. So instead of Google went to Maven, so they went to Gradle support. So what is a Gradle is? Gradle is a library for us, okay, which will download from the internet. So to make what are the libraries we are downloading from the internet, it will place in our application, okay, to make our application very simple, and it will generate the output. Okay, later I am going to be display for you where it is available in our applications. Okay, just as of now, you have to remember Gradle is a tool. Gradle is a tool to create an Android application, and it is responsible to make your application executable. Okay, just remember that. When I start learning about teaching you about the application creation, how an application is executing, at that time I am going to be explain you more about Gradle. Because of the reason Gradle, we must use Android Studio only. Okay, so this is the technical reason. That is the reason we have to use Android Studio IDE. Okay, you can download today. What you can do, you can download Android Studio IDE for the Java environment from Oracle website. You can download JDK as well as JRE. Okay, try to download JDK environment, JRE environment. Okay, so that means J2SC. That's enough for me. Other than this, nothing is required for me. Okay, just keep it aside. Next, coming to the part of application development. So just I am giving you the introduction. I am not writing any code today. So code slowly I am going to be start. Okay. So what the way I am going to be teach to you Android application development. See, my way of class is, first I will introduce the concept. The concept is based on basics, intermediate level, top level. How the concepts will go? Basic level, intermediate level, high end level. So in the basic level, first I'll make you understand the first part of Android user interface, Android graphical user interface. So what is this GraphQL user interface it contains? So you must learn about XML language, extensive markup language. Don't worry, I may need to learn extensive markup language again. So how to do that, don't get worried. No need to worry, okay? So XML is very simple and it's so easy to understand, okay? So just you need to know basic things. Those basic idea also I am going to be provide to you. You can just attend my session, that's it, okay? So this is the XML code. And more probably, everything is drag and drop. I need a button that is available here. You just drag and drop. I need a checkbox in the palette. This is called palette window, which is available for me. So from there, you can download. Like this, you have to write backend module. How to do the memory analysis? All those things I'm going to teach. Okay. So XML basic knowledge I am going to be provided to you. First, what I will do in the XML concepts, I'll make you understand what is a view and what is a view. Basic concepts. So how to write XML logic? Okay. After that, what kind of views are available in the Android? Like what are all we are dragging and dropping, how to handle its event in the sense, for example, button is there, you are clicking on button. So how to handle clicking on a button? Checkbox is there, checkbox have check uncheck, how to handle check uncheck? Okay. So Wi-Fi switch is there, how to make on off kind of thing. Okay, we have different kind of words. Technically I am going to be write something here. Views and view groups. After that, compound buttons. These are all technical things. Compound buttons. Okay. Adapter views. So what are the adapter views we have? All these things, these are basic level. Okay. After that, I will take to you adapter views with the custom level, intermediate. Intermediate is in the sense custom list view. So how you are going to be generate a custom list view? So what is a custom list view? See, let me show you how a custom list view will be there. This is a custom list view. Okay. This is a custom list view. You are going to be create custom list view kind of thing. So this is intermediate level. Okay. After that, after making you understanding all these things, I am going to be start a material design concept, which is high end. Material design concepts. So don't get confused here. Whenever I am writing, making you understand all these things, parallelly I'll make you understand how to create a Android backend, how to write a Android backend, front end GUI, backend logic. So material design concepts are very highly advanced. Okay. So these things I am going to take. So all these things, even I am going to be explain along with the backend. So what is there in Android backend? Okay. So in Android backend, it's so very simple. If you understand, it is very simple. Only 5 core components are available. Other than this, nothing is available for us. I'll try to elaborate or make you understand very simple manner. First core component is activity. So what is activity here is, but before learning these components, you just need J2SC, core Java. I hope all of you know core Java, right? So core Java, other name, standard edition. Okay, don't call core Java in the company. You have to call it as standard edition. If you know or you are thorough in the OOPS concepts, that's enough for me. Object oriented concepts. Because rest of the things, these will take care. Okay. So here, everything, backend means you are going to be create dot Java file. Frontend means what you will create? You will create dot XML file. User interface. So what do you mean by activity is activity is nothing but it's a combination of .xml file plus .java file executing together to display on the user interface, to display on the mobile screen. I'm displaying one screen. That is nothing but I have created one activity. So my activity is displayed on the mobile screen. That's the reason your front end is displayed. When you are clicking on the button, the backend logic is handling. So what is that here? Activity. So in my application, for example, I have 10 screens. That means how many activities I have to create? 10 activities I have to create. So what is an activity? Activity is nothing but it's a graphical user interface component. But before that, activity is a predefined component for us. So that predefined object or component have some predefined lifecycle methods. How an activity is going to be executed, all those things I'm going to be start with. Okay, how we can create an activity, how it is going to be executed. For example, in my screen, in my application, I have 100 screens. So 100 screens means I have to create 100 activities. Or is there any other alternative way to create other than activity? Yes, we have alternate way other than activity. We have to use fragments. We have to use adapters. So all these things I am going to be discuss. Adapters, fragments, all these things I am going to be invoke for you. Next, second core component. Intent you have. So what is intent? I'll make communication between multiple screens. For example, I told I have 10 screens. That means once login screen completed, you have to go to dashboard screen. From there, your module screen. From there, it's a sub screen kind of thing. So your application need to navigate from one screen to another screen. How it will happen? Because of the intent. Okay. Next, the third component you have, which is services. Service is nothing but it's also a component, but which will execute always in the background, which doesn't contain any user interface. User interface, it don't have. For example, I have a mobile which is inserted with the SIM card. You have your personal mobile. You and me are both are friends. So I'll call you. You will receive a call. How you are receiving a call? With the presence of SIM only, right? If the SIM is there, it has a particular number and it is communicating with the network. So network, who will take care? Telephony manager will take care. So telephony manager is a service which is available in the service component, which is a core component in Android backend. Location, telephony manager, okay, content providers, all these services we are going to be learning. Bluetooth, Wi-Fi, all these things are available for us. Even vibration, if you would like to make a vibration, how your device make vibration, that is also available in the service. Everything is with the service only. Everything is with the service only. Next thing you will have, fourth component, which is broadcast receiver. Broadcast receiver. It is also like a service, but the thing is, broadcast receiver is used to register a system or application event to perform in the future. Example, alarm. Morning 5 a.m. I would like to wake up so that I would like to keep an alarm. But the alarm I will register now itself. But exactly 5 a.m. I will get the alarm. So that is kind of broadcast receiver. Static. Dynamic broadcast messages we will have, and you will have content provider. Content provider is nothing but database. How Android is allowed to store the data internally, how contacts and SMS you received are storing in the database. That database I am going to be introduced to you. How can I share my database with another application? That we are going to be discuss. Along with this extra concepts, integration of web service. So what is integration of web service? Means some web programs are available. Web service is nothing but it's a program actually, which was implemented by web application. For example, now you have Crickinfo, Facebook, WhatsApp, like any of your friend posted something, you will get some data, you are able to see the data. That means where your friend is posting, not on your wall, on his wall he is posting. That means the data, whatever he is posting the data, that will be loaded into the server, external server, whether it is be MySQL, SQL or Oracle. So that data using a web service, that will be loaded into your Facebook application so that you are able to see. So what is a web service, how to integrate web service, that we are going to be learning. Along with that, how to integrate Google Maps in our Android application, and what are the Firebase cloud messaging notification. Okay, how to create a Google Analytics, all those things I am going to be discussed during our course. So total overall duration is consider from 45 to 50 hours. Okay, it's completely 45 to 50 hours or 50 days you can calculate. So every day I used to take 1 hour 15 minutes or 1 hour 20 minutes. Okay, so during weekend I will take some extra time. Okay, these are all. Don't worry, everything will be in a sequence manner, like how a fresher will be learned. Okay, that kind of training I am going to be provided to you. Okay, so this is the demo, which what are all the things I am going to be discussed with you. So that's I have provided. I hope you understand. So who are all not provided email ID yesterday, requesting you to please provide your email ID so that I'll share with Durgasoft people, so that you will get a call from the Durgasoft from the Durgasoft. Okay, so yesterday I received Rakesh Kumar. Yeah, I received Vikram, right? Sorry, Vikram. Achcha, you are already 90 MS, right? Okay, sorry. Venu, Rajesh Kumar, and Jagdish Reddy. Have you provided your email ID? Yeah, Jagdish, you have provided, I guess. You are able to see this, right? And Ritesh. Is Ritesh available? No. Venu? So requesting you to please provide your mobile number as well as email ID. We won't misuse it. So Durgasoft will get in touch with you. So to follow up with you, if you are interested, you will get the videos. If you don't register your email ID, mobile number, you won't get any assistance. And the recorded videos also you won't get anything. So that's the reason I'm requesting. Rakesh as well as Jagdish has already provided, I guess. Venu, Rakesh. Please provide your email ID and mobile number. I'll forward it with the Durga sir so that they will follow up with you. If you are interested to join with me, please be joined. Any queries do you have? If you have any queries, please let me know. So requesting you to please message me your details so that I can inform to Durgasoft so that they will they'll be get in touch with you. When yesterday you attended or today only you attended? Please provide your details. Not interested to provide. If you have any queries, please let me know. I'll share with them. Nothing I will do. You are unable to type any message or you are unable to talk. Okay, guys, what we will discuss tomorrow, if you are really interested to join. So tomorrow I am going to explain to you how to install Android Studio and how to set up Java environment. After that, I am going to start first concept. How Android front end will be designed, that we'll discuss. Okay, if you are interested, you can join tomorrow also, but please provide your details so that we'll be in get in touch with you. Hope you understand and share me the details, or else if you have any queries, please let me know. Okay. Looks no one have any query. Okay then. Thanks, guys. Thanks for joining. We'll meet again tomorrow. What we are going to be discussed tomorrow, that is setup Android as well as start XML coding. That we will do. Okay, guys. Thanks for joining. See you tomorrow. Thank you.